Bobby. Sounds like I might be looking for a trip to Herefordshire.
Are you now? Where's Scotland?
Tavers. I've got tavers left.
I'm going then if I were you.
I've got tavers left.
Every girl's got her price list, and mine's Fatlands, not Penny Less. Got me self-respect, you know.
I've got tavers.
Oh, no, get off! Get off, you drunken sod! Get off! Oh, cheeky bleeder. I'm a nice girl.
Watch.
I must speak with Professor Garner. It is really most urgent.
meeting, Mom. Sorry about the interruption.
East Coast, it's 2 in the morning, Han. I was having the strangest dream. No, it's gone, but I'm sure it'll come back to me.
It's been another murder, Professor Gardner. Police surgeons had a look, but to be frank, I've never seen anything like it, and nor has he. And you were such a help with the case of the Bethnal vampire.
Couldn't it wait?
The body's only a few hours fresh, Mom. It's a spring heeled jack again. You know what happens to the bodies. Another day, you'll have to keep it in a bucket. What's that say? Where's that coming from?
A nice study. It's all right, Chief Inspector. I hope.
Ah, Professor!
Doctor! I had a ship materialise. I had no idea it was yours.
Just popping by for a cup of tea and a chat and all that.
Oh, do excuse us, Chief Inspector. This is an old student of mine. I put him in xenobotany at the Academy.
I do believe introductions are in order.
Oh, yes. This is Chief Inspector Potts of Scotland Yard.
Chief Inspector Potts, how delightful. I'm the Doctor. And this is my companion, Chitara, a steel Valkyrie.
Slow death to your enemies.
Charmed, I'm sure, miss. Are you with the opera?
Delightful. From the US, can't you say? There's a rare species of chameleon blood orchid that grows there. Have you ever seen a flower with teeth?
Do you think I'm sorry that I have, Professor Gardner.
It is often the last thing people do see.
This is all very nice, Professor, but...
Oh, I do apologise, Chief Inspector Thorne. Fetch a cab.
Why does that servant wear a mask?
Chitara! You must excuse Professor. She has no sense of decorum. She has 50 ways to kill a man, yet doesn't know how to use a knife and fork. Unless, of course, it's to kill a man. Why does he wear a mask for all this stuff?
There was a terrible fire. I'm sure you understand. The poor man was horribly disfigured.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are we interrupting something?
Just a little business I have to attend to. If you'd care to wait back here, I'll be with you shortly.
Right, queer business it is, too.
Ooh, anything I can help with?
But I really wouldn't
want to. Oh, suffer not.
I really don't think...
No, I would appreciate another professional opinion.
Is there danger?
Half a dozen people have met horrible deaths under mysterious circumstances, miss.
Excellent. Oh! If you've made up your minds, I certainly have no intention of going to a morgue in my pyjamas! I'll be with you shortly, gentlemen!
Right then. Oh, I'm sorry, Doctor. I don't believe I called your name.
No, I don't believe you did.
No! not enough. That tart of his dies!
Let him just bring your jack again! Oh. No, it was arrogant, you were nearly caught this time!
That petty dreadful reject. Again, what's he want with you?
We don't know, at least we don't!
Please, don't make me kill again!
Shut it! I'm talking to the organ grinder, not a monkey! You owe me, Johnny!
Look, we do this, you leave us alone!
We'll consider it.
Not the other way around. I can live with that.
quite understand. It is very different here.
I don't doubt it, miss.
No, that my world has not known true peace since the great galactic breakdown. It is a harsh world. Our ancestors were harsh people. It is in our blood. We have a say. You are no greater than the life you take. There is no glory in killing the weak. The strong and willing fight only each other. I think it is very different here. Inspector Potts.
Yes, miss?
Are you mated?
Astonishing, quite astonishing.
Yes, indeed.
Doctor, Professor, please have a seat.
I've never seen a biological process quite like it before.
Like what?
Like whatever kills... What was his name?
Edwin Tully.
Yes, Tully. Poor fellow. Anyway, the blood was sucked from Tully's vein whilst a highly corrosive biological agent...
Chlorophyll-based?
Yes, chlorophyll-based. Possibly even from the body of the actual assailant. Anyway, this agent was pumped into Tully's veins, and then seconds later, his original blood, now be it all minus various important salts and important nutrients, was circulated back again. This caused widespread tumorous growth and total cellular dissolution.
Even the bones, even those, it is quite a weapon.
Weapon? It's clearly some sort of feeding process.
Oh, really, Doctor, I can't concur. That's pure supposition. I know of no life form that feeds this way. An animal which stores its own blood in its prey while it feeds.
Possibly not an animal. No, xenobotany is your area of expertise. I just think it's an enormously convoluted way of killing somebody.
Do you know what they're talking about?
I rarely do, even after he explains. I sometimes think that if I was not here, people would not even know what was going on. Sometimes when we play this game called chess, have you heard of it on this planet?
Beg your pardon, miss?
It's all right.
Chess is from this planet.
I thought it was Gallifrey.
Oh, no. We have... I suppose Rassilon's Gambit is the closest.
Ah, yes. I haven't played that in a very long time.
And that is like chess, is it? He defeats me at chess. I should like to play this game of Rassilon.
Rassilon's Gambit. The game of Rassilon is something else entirely.
You have two games of Rassilon.
Oh, what a mess. And we have the Eye of Rassilon, the Robe of Rassilon, the Flange of Rassilon. We pretty much have an everything of Rassilon.
But besides, only a Time Lord can play it, I'm afraid.
Right. Well, science has had its crack. We can't figure out how it was done, we'll just have to have a look at the why of it. I always say, if you're missing parts of a puzzle, you just have to look at the pieces that you do have.
Oh, well, I like him.
I do too.
So do I, very much so.
We've had four murders in the last 3 months. Louisa Atkins, Sally Dwyer, Mary Bainbridge, and now Edwin Tuller. At the scene of each murder, a tall figure dressed in dark clothing is seen, but he apparently flies away like a bird. So there's no leads there. He's the one they call the Springfield Jack. Louisa Atkins and Mary Bainbridge are working. Well, one Dougie Harper, Sally's wife, she's a poor stoker and a portionist. She works for Harper as well. He's a nasty piece of work, this Harper. Runs a blackmail gang south of the river. His main wife is another thug by the name of Collins. Two of them have been at each other's throats for years.
Seems unlikely that Victorian street gangs have the power to do this to one another. What do we know of Tully?
Not much. Only just arrived in London, as far as we can tell. No fixed trade. He was living in a doss house close to where he was killed. However, when he was killed, he was talking to one Peggy Maguire, and she's another one of Harper's girls, and she's walking out with him to be.
Only women have been victims until now. Is this important?
I hope not. I mean, has it not occurred to you that this Maguire may have been the Springfield Jack's next intended victim?
Well, yeah, it has, but we couldn't question her for long. I can't put a man on the lot in that part of the East End. She'd scream blue bloody murder. Still, I reckon I'll cue another word or two with Miss Maguire.
It occurs to me that this young lady may be in some danger.
Excellent. Sorry.
No, there's something wrong.
Something very dangerous. Oh, well. Thanks for your support.
No, I don't like this.
Where is it? Where is it?
Whoosh.
Oi! You can't stand around here!
Why not? What have I done?
You old travel, Peggy. Clear up!
Why should I clear up? I ain't done nothing.
People gets killed when you girls is around. No one wants you, alright?
No, you didn't say that last night.
Said it could clear up!
I know it's going to be hard, I do. Just you wait till I tell him about all this.
Hopper.
Yeah.
That dead duck. It's funny, ain't it? How it's only these girls kick the bucket. Look, it ain't safe. Go home, alright?
Common equipment, but no markings on his uniform.
So,
We know no more than before, and he has claimed another life.
I'm surprised you can still think that.
Well, he is the most likely suspect.
No, he's the only suspect. Advanced hardware. This Spring Hill Jack uses alien technology, but I've seen no bioweapons, nothing biological.
Whatever killed Tully was organic in nature. Do you know, I think some sort of creature is responsible for these murders, and whoever that is hunting it.
Shatara, you all right?
Oh, I declare a blood for you, Donut.
Good to see you're feeling better. You see, Professor, this mystery man could have killed Shatara.
I defeated him in fair combat.
Now, he defeated you in unfair combat. Fortune favors the sneaky, remember? And if instead of a flash grenade, you use, say, a fusion device?
All right.
What happens now? I have other business to attend to. I'll get Thorn to take you back to the house. You are, of course, my guests.
Thank you. I've got much to think about.
Now, I know why
Jesus!
Doctor!
Run, Shatara! If Thorne's what I think it is, you can't fight him!